Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we are discussing about loop control structures in detail. So in the previous video, we are discussing about what is loop control structures, advantages of loop control structures, why loop control structures, and types of loop control structures, and comparison and differences between loop control structures are discussed. In this video, we are discussing about algorithms. Okay. So in this video, we are discussing about while syntax and flowchart. Do-while syntax and flowchart, for syntax and flowchart, write a Java program to print first n natural numbers using three loops. I will explain using three loops. Okay. Now the first one is while syntax. In the while, first one is the initialization. Second is the condition. Next is the iterator. These three are common in three loops. You can remember that. Initialization, condition, and iterators are common in three loops. Okay, so initial value is defined. Later, we need to check the condition. If the condition is true, then the statements will be executed, and followed by iterations are done. Iteration is nothing but either, in general, it is incrementation or decrementation. But moreover, sometimes it is a division, or sometimes it is adding more number. That's why it is iterator, not increment by decrement. Okay, generally most of the textbooks or most of the people's thought or teach like that, iterator, not iterator, increment by decrement. But here actually it is an iterator. In the latter section, you can better understand why I am using iterator is the right word. Okay, so keep on running until unless the condition is false. Okay, now based on this, I am draw the flowchart for this. First one is the initialization, followed by condition. If this is yes, statements followed by iterator. Until unless it is true. If it is no, directly we come out from the loop. This is how the while flowchart will represents. Okay, now I am moving to the next one, that is do while. Do while, first one is the initialization, next is the statements, next is the iterator, followed by condition. So okay, at the end we are also putting semicolon. So I think you understand very clearly about do while. So while is the entry control loop, do while is the exist control loop. Why? Because we are checking condition at the last. Okay, that is why in do while the statements will be executed at least once. Okay, the flowchart representation initialization, statements, do not think this is not a special symbol, actually it is a rectangular. Okay, here we need to check the condition. This is true, then yes, no, come out of the process. This is how the do while is working. Okay, finally, so we are discussing about for syntax and flowchart, for initialization, condition, and iterator, the statements. And at the same time, we also know that for having one more type, that is for each, for type var array statements using var. Okay, so for this I am draw the flow chart. Okay, for initialization condition iterator. This is how the mechanism works. Okay, in the for each, it is a group of elements like type def or enum or array etc of data is available that is stored in a type of var, and using that var we are accessing all the data of the all the elements of the array or type def or enum or string etc with this support. Okay, I think you understand so very clearly. So now when compared to this is in finite loop, and while and do while are infinite loops. While and do are infinite loops, and for is finite loop. That is what exactly important point we are left from the process. Okay, so the second point is, and while and these three loops, three things are common. One is initialization, second one is condition, third one is iterator, but they are placing in different positions based on the syntaxes changes. I think you understand very clearly about these things. Okay, now I am moving to a small program. Write a Java program to print first n natural numbers using three loops. So regarding while, initially I need to put int I is equal to 1. Okay, let us assume n is equal to 10 while I less than equal to n. System dot out dot println I. So after 1 will be printed, we need to print I will become 2. So I plus plus or I is equal to I plus 1. We can use any one of the way. So automatically it concludes the process. So similarly, when go to do while int I is equal to 1, n is equal to 10, okay, do system dot out dot println I plus plus I is equal to I plus 1 while I less than equal to n. This is the second way of representation. So for int I is equal to 1, I less than equal to n, I plus plus system dot out dot println I. This is the way we are representing the same program in three loops. The number of lines are increasing or the number of lines are decreasing based on the things, but the output will generate same. There is no difference. Okay, I think you hope I hope you understand the concept very clearly. Thank you.